Okay, things kind of got away from me on Groot here. It was just kind of cool, and I was just getting into it. But here's the quick and dirty, down and dirty catch-up routine. So we took the Americana, burnt umber, and we gave him two coats, which made him nice and dark. You can see here how dark it was. Okay. Then after he was dry, we took the teddy bear. And using the dry brush technique where you put a little bit on your brush, you wipe it off, and you just kind of go over and over and just kind of applying the paint to the highlights. It gives him the look you see here, brings out all the details, and everything is cool. After that, what I did is I took a combination of the two. I think it was like three parts teddy bear, one part Americana, mixed it up, and I did the pads of his feet. All right. There's a couple vines. We can get into this real quick. There's a couple vines. This camera really sucks. But there's a couple vines going through him here. There's one across his back here. On his arm. I can't see his arm because it's up here. Going across his arm. Up in here. Those were done with what I use? A kittle ash. Just use deep green. It's an acrylic from Tamiya. Just use that to highlight those. So that got the vines. I'm going to start working now. I'd like to start working on his eyes. So I started by putting a dark black coat of paint for his eyes, and we're going to do some detailing from there. But that's where he is right now. I'm pretty pleased with it. I think he's looking pretty good, but we still have a little bit more to go. We did, like I said, we're going to do his eyes. We're going to do a little bit of green highlights from like the mossy like stuff for his crown, around his feet, stuff like that. So we're going to get onto that next. All right, so stay tuned. Okay, guys, welcome back to the lost video footage reel. Yeah, we don't have the footage of doing this originally. I've really lost my edge. Not that I was really good at it before, but I've really gone back like five notches in the way I used to make my videos. But I'm trying to get better at it. I appreciate those of you that stick with me throughout this crap. But anyway, here's what we are. We took our Groot. We're gonna do our eyes. We took our Groot, and we started by painting his eyes black. In the show, I believe they're just black eyes, but want to add more detail to the eyes, give him more depth. So what we did is we started again. We painted him black. And then after that was dry, we took this red acrylic paint and we painted little hash marks all around the exterior, not well, the edges of the eyes. Little hard to see, but that's what it is here. So you got those red lines coming down from the ex, you know, the from the outside towards the center of where his pupil would be if he had pupils, okay? So we did that. So after the red, we took some yellow and we painted yellow in there, okay? And again, it looks goofy right now, I admit it, but we put yellow in there. Once that dried, I got a darker crimson red and painted that over top of the yellow. And again, this is the effect we got, and we let that dry. Next, we got ourselves some gloss black, and we painted over all of the eyes. Well, we painted around and made a big pupil and left, like, there's some edges here. It's hard to see in this picture, but there's some edges here in the inside of his eyes that you can actually see those colors coming together, kind of like this. So it adds some dimension, and you can't see it. Once that was dried, I took a clear gloss acrylic over top of it to give it a glossy look. And now we've got some Groot eyes. Kind of cool. As a little deviation from our project, I found this online, and I just had to do it. I thought I'd throw it in here. This is Baby Yoda, or Grogu, as for those that follow along on the Mandalorian show. He's cute, right? Yeah, he's a cute little thing that I found online. We printed him out, painted him up. You can see here, nothing fancy, just went all over it, just quick one and done type thing. I think he only took about maybe an hour to print. Like I said, we just fastly printed, painted him up. And then what you do with once you have this is you put it on your toothpaste. And when you squeeze your toothpaste, Grogu spits up. Ah, too cool. My daughter loved this. I thought it was funny as shit. Funny as heck. So we've got another 3D print of baby Grogu vomiting toothpaste. Something we can actually use every day. All right, quick update on Groot. What I started to do is I'm working on his mossy color. Again, I don't know that he had too much in the show because he was young. He wasn't like the older Groot that they had it. But I'm just trying to make some detail to it. So we're adding some to his crown, and I'm using is pastels. You can see here. Okay, what this is I took my pastels. I got these pastels, and I file them down on some sandpaper, and I started with this light color here, this green, added that to him around the crown and around the feet, a little bit on the hands. Then I went to this next color. Okay. Added that on top of it, and then I added this dark green to the mix and mixed it all together with the other lighter colors. And then we dabbed it on. Now it looks quite a bit right now. So we take over top where we did it, brushing it off, blending it in. Okay. And then again, it looks like a lot, to be honest with you right now, but we're going to end up giving this a gloss coat and a wash, and it's going to tone all that down and hopefully blend it in and make it look a little bit better. So that's where we are right now. Some more of that. I got to do the top of his head too. And then I would like to also, I got to see if I have any, some actual fine grass from the train setups. You know, we use that on different kits. And if I can add some more in it to make it a little bit more three-dimensional. So that's where we are with baby Groot. All right.